Welcome back. I am Neha Paryani. In today's session, we will discuss about types of cooperative societies. So let's get started. Types of cooperative societies. Before going for the types of cooperative societies, first of all, we need to understand what is a cooperative society, right? So while discussing the concept, we came to know its detailed meaning, right? So let's revise it. A cooperative society is a voluntary association of persons who join together with the motive of welfare of its members. So we know that it is a voluntary association, right? So any person who has attained the age of 18 years and have a common interest can join the cooperative society. And any group of persons having common interest, that is minimum of 10 members, a group of minimum 10 members who have common interest can easily form a cooperative society, right? So it works for the motive, it works with the motive of welfare of its members. So it is a service providing organization, right? So it is very necessary to have a common interest between all the members of the cooperative society. Okay, now let's head on to types of cooperative societies. So they are based upon the nature and the operations performed by them. Okay, so basically there are six types of cooperative societies. They are consumers cooperative society, producers cooperative society, marketing cooperative societies, farmers cooperative society, credit cooperative societies, and cooperative housing societies. Okay, so in this session we will discuss about first three types of cooperative societies. In my next session we will discuss the rest three. Okay, so let's begin for now. The first type is consumers cooperative society, right? As the name suggests, consumer cooperative societies are formed by a group of consumers, right? So why they are formed? What is the purpose of a consumer's cooperative society? It is the consumer cooperative societies are formed to protect the interest of consumers. So basically they work for the welfare of consumers, that is its members, right? So they provide services to various consumers. Next, who are its members? The members comprises of consumers desirous of obtaining good quality products at reasonable prices. So it consists of lots of consumers who desire to obtain good quality products at reasonable prices, right? So they want quality products but at affordable prices, not at higher prices, right? So what is the aim of a consumers cooperative society? To eliminate middlemen and achieve economy in operations. So first of all, they want to eliminate middlemen. So while discussing the concept of cooperative societies, we came to know that the main objective of a cooperative society is to eliminate middlemen, right? So who are these middlemen? So basically they are the agents or retailers, small shopkeepers who purchases goods from wholesalers or manufacturers and add their higher profit margin, then they sell the goods to the final customer. So because of the higher profit margin added by the middlemen, the cost of that product becomes automatically more, right? Hence the customers get it for higher prices, right? So these consumer cooperative societies aims at eliminating these middlemen. And when they eliminate the middlemen, they will automatically achieve economy in their operations, right? The cost of the product will be reduced, hence they achieve economy in their operations, right? So now the question arises, what are the operations of a consumer cooperative society? So what basically actually what these societies do, it purchases goods in bulk directly from wholesalers and sells goods to the members at cheaper prices by eliminating middlemen. So what they do is they purchase directly goods from wholesalers or manufacturers and then they sell it to its customers. So here there are no middlemen, right? So here when there are no middlemen, there is no extra profit margin, right? So whatever they purchase from manufacturers or wholesalers, they add their profit margin at very lesser rate, that is 1 or 2%, then sell it to the final consumers, right? Hence the consumers will be able to get qualitative products at lesser price when compared to a retail shop, right? Hence they will be successful at eliminating middlemen. Next, so whatever the profits earned by cooperative societies, how they are going to be shared by its members? So profits are distributed on the basis of either their capital contribution to the society or purchases made by individuals. So basically the profits are divided as per the ratio of capital contributed by them. So we know that in this type of business organization, the capital is pooled up by issuing shares, right? So it may depend upon the number of shares purchased by the members in the cooperative society or on the basis of ratio of purchases which is made by individual members, okay? So now what are the examples of cooperative society? They are Apna Bazaar, Janta Bazaars and supermarkets. In these type of outlets, you can find the products at very lesser rate when compared to other retail shops, right? So because they purchase goods from manufacturers directly, okay? Along with the lesser prices, you will find lots and lots of variety as well, right? So they deal with all FMCG goods, that is fast moving consumable goods, which we use in our day-to-day life. Okay, so these are few examples of a consumer cooperative society. Right. So basically the concept of consumer cooperative society is that its main aim is to protect the welfare of the consumers by eliminating the middlemen. So how they will eliminate the middlemen? By purchasing the goods directly from wholesalers and manufacturers and adding very lesser profit margin and then selling it to its final members, that is consumers. Okay. Hence they will be successful at eliminating the middlemen as well as achieving the economy in their operations. Next type is producers cooperative society. So these societies are formed by a group of producers. Okay. So the purpose of forming a producers cooperative society is to protect the interest of small producers. Okay. So they work for the welfare of small producers or they provide services to small producers. Okay. So the members of cooperative society consists of producers desirous of procuring inputs for production of goods. So we know that while manufacturing goods, we need certain inputs, right? Like raw materials, right? So this consists of producers who desire to procure or to obtain the raw materials at lesser prices. Okay. So the aim of producer cooperative society is to fight against the big capitalists and enhance the bargaining power of small producers. So the bargaining power of small producers is very, very less, right? So they cannot sell the goods to the customers at lesser prices, because when they sell it for the lesser prices, they will earn very less profit, or even there are chances they may face the losses, right? So because big capitalists sells their products at very lesser prices, right? Because they produce in larger quantities, they can afford to sell it at very lesser prices. So there is hell lot of competition, right? So in order to enhance the bargaining power of the small producers, these producers cooperative society is formed. Okay. Next. So what are its operations? It supplies raw materials, equipments and other inputs to the members and also buys their output for sale. So as I said earlier, for production we need raw materials, right? So these consumers, these producers cooperative societies supplies raw materials to small producers. Along with raw materials, they also provide certain equipments which will help them for producing the goods, right? So after production, they buy their goods in order to sell them to the final customers. So these are the operations performed by a producers cooperative society. Okay. So whatever the profits earned by these type of organization is distributed on the basis of their contribution to the total pool of goods produced or sold by the society. So it depends upon the ratio on which the goods are produced by its members, or the ratio on which the sales are made by this type of societies. Right. So the examples for producers cooperative societies are Amul Cooperatives or KMF, that is Karnataka Milk Federation. Right. So we all know Amul company produces various dairy products. Right. In order to produce dairy products, they will require milk. Right. So Amul Cooperatives purchases milk from various small milk vendors and then produce goods. Then it makes packaging and sells with the name of Amul to general public, right? So hence this is an example of producers cooperative. In the same way, Karnataka Milk Federation, right? So this was all about producers cooperative society. The third type is marketing cooperative society. So even this type of society is formed by producers, okay, a group of producers. So why marketing cooperative society is formed? It is established to help small producers in selling their products. Okay, so the producers market cooperative society was formed in order to help them to produce the goods, right? And this type of society is formed to help the producers in selling their products, if so, to market their products. The member consists of producers who wish to obtain reasonable prices for their output. So it consists of members who produce the goods and then they want to sell it to general public and want to attain at least reasonable prices for the products produced by them, right? So the aims of marketing cooperative society are to eliminate middlemen. Again, the same aim, to eliminate middlemen and improve competitive position of its members by securing a favorable market for the products. So here, so when the producers want to sell their products to general public, so they will appoint certain middlemen, right? So like agents or brokers who will sell their products, but they will charge their profit margin again. So in order, the marketing cooperative societies will eliminate the middlemen and hence they secure a favorable market for their members, okay, for their small producers, right? Next, operations. It pools the output of individual members and perform marketing functions like transportation, warehousing, packaging. So it pools out output in the sense that it collects the products which are produced by the small producers from the individual members, that is small producers, and then it sells to various other customers. Okay, so hence they create market for their products, right? And they also perform certain marketing functions like transportation. In order to reach the goods from manufacturer to a final customer, transportation is necessary, right? So it performs the functions like transportation, warehousing in the sense storing the goods and packaging, etc. So these all are the operations performed by the marketing cooperative societies. Next, the profit are distributed according to each member's contribution to the pool of output. Again, here the same. The profits are distributed upon the ratio of the contribution made by them towards the total products. Okay. Next, examples are, best example is an APMC. So it is a market for agricultural products. Okay. Various farmers who cultivate food grains will join here in this type of market and sells their products collectively. Okay, so whoever wants to purchase the food grains, that is agricultural products, can directly go into this types of market and purchase the goods, right? So this is an example for agricultural products, right? In the same way, there are many fruit markets, vegetable markets, etc., right? So these are the examples for marketing cooperative society. This was all about a marketing cooperative society. So this was all about today. If you found this helpful, please hit the like button. Also subscribe to my channel. For any questions and queries, you can ask me in the comment section below. Hope to see you in my next videos. Till that, happy learning.